So for a lot of those guys, they've never done something like this before. Yasmin's never danced in front of a crowd by herself, and my son definitely hasn't had the main role in a Christmas play before, and so they did a really good job. All right. Christmas is kind of a weird... Oh, my name's Michael. I'm the pastor here at the church. I'm going to try and lose my accent now. So it keeps creeping back. Christmas is kind of a weird celebration. We have snowflakes on our Christmas tree, and we do Frosty the Snowman Christmas craft, and we sing of a white Christmas, but we're in Australia where there's not a speck of snow in sight. What we have is often bushfires. And then there's a Santa in every shopping mall. When my son Sam, when he was younger, he couldn't understand how there was a Santa in like the Myers and a Santa in the food hall at the same time. It kind of boggled his little mind. And then the Christmas movie of the younger generation is like Elf or The Christmas Chronicles, and for the older generation, it's Die Hard. And we our email boxes are full of catalogs and shopping choices that we need to buy. Apparently, I need to upgrade my TV to 5K. I didn't even know that was a thing now. And my, one of the presents I really need to buy my kids is to upgrade them to a PS5. My kids. We have all these messages bombard us in Christmas time. But Christmas is not about snow, and it's not about Santa, and it's not about sanity deteriorating family lunches either. It's about something else. The slogan goes, many of you may know it, the reason for the season is Jesus. Well, it's about baby Jesus then, right? That's what we're celebrating today. Well, yes and no. See, Christmas isn't so much about celebrating the baby as it is celebrating who that baby will grow to become, what that baby will grow to do, the miracles he would perform, the teaching he would speak, the sacrifice he would lay down, the resurrection that would be brought, for the baby grew to be the king. Now, I mean, that was kind of one of the main things from the Christmas play, right? He's the king, monkey moo! Yeah, my wife was still wondering what that accent was. And it's a little bit weird for us, this concept of Jesus as the king, because in Australians, we're not really a fan of kingship and authority, and that dates back to our convict roots. And we don't really have modern kings like they used to. Ancient kings used to have wealth and power, and modern day royalty has fodder for gossip magazines. I mean, we have the queen, but she definitely doesn't have the power and respect that the kings of old used to have. And as a result, we hear the word king, and we're a little bit reluctant to accept it. But in ancient times, kings were deified as gods, as messiahs, as saviors. And so when Jesus comes, he comes as the one true king, the one true messiah, the one true savior, the one that all the other kingships were meant to be and meant to look like. But here, the Bible says that Jesus is king. Well, where do I get that from? Great question. The first thing is Jesus is born in royal bloodline. He's born on the line of David. And so just like Prince Harry is born in the line of Queen Elizabeth, so he's got royal bloodline, so was the same with Jesus. And then when an angel tells Mary that she is going to give birth, the angel says, tells her that he will be the king and have the throne of his father, King David, Luke 1:32. And then Jesus is treated like a king at his birth. The wise men see a star and interpret that to mean that a king had come. And so what they do is when they get into the area where Jesus was, they go straight to the palace because that's where they would expect a king to be born. King Herod is sitting there at the time and he's got no idea what's going on. And he's so perplexed about this idea that a king has been born that he says to wipe out a generation of young boys to make sure that that king never grows up. But Joseph is warned by an angel and Jesus escapes to Egypt and comes back after that king leaves and is no longer there. And then Jesus says he is a king. At his trial, before his crucifixion, he's in a conversation with Pilate and says, "My kingdom is not of this world. But now my kingdom is from another place." When Jesus died as a king. He died because he said he was the king of the Jews, and there was a sign above him on the cross saying, "King of the Jews." And Jesus will return as king. For Jesus' kingship has started, but it's not completed yet. It won't be completed until Christ returns, until Jesus comes back and brings all of those who are his, all of those who have agreed to him, all of those who have obeyed by his rules and have a relationship with Jesus, will come and be with Jesus, with him, with God, for eternity. So Jesus is king. But it raises the question, is Jesus our king? See, at Christmas time, we kind of have two versions of Jesus, right? And we got the baby Jesus, and we're really comfortable with baby Jesus. Baby Jesus is cute and adorable, especially played with so adorably by Isaiah. We practiced that, he nailed it. It was fantastic, it was a week. And we like that baby Jesus. And all the shepherds and the wise men around the manger, like we're happy with that little, oh, baby Jesus is so cute. But we're a little bit more uncomfortable with King Jesus. The Jesus who came to rule. The Jesus who came that we may submit our lives to him and be in a relationship with him. A Jesus that we enter his kingship. Well, we're not as comfortable with that version of Jesus. We're okay with the baby Jesus, but right, King Jesus, But it's the same Jesus. You can't take one without the other. At Christmas, the tendency is we go, yay, baby, but let's ignore the king. But the true story of Christmas is that Jesus is king. He was born to die. He was born that we might have our sins forgiven. He was born so we could come into a relationship with him. He was born so that through his death and resurrection, we would know him, that we would know God, that he would be our king. So this Christmas, the question that I want you to ask yourself, is Jesus your king? For like Sam said in the play, Jesus is king, but how do I respond to that? Jesus is king. How will you respond to that? Please let me pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for the kids' Christmas play. We thank you for the kids, and they did such an amazing job, and we really praise you for that. But Lord, we pray that you will remind us what the real reason for Christmas is. As we start to put up the trees, finalize our Christmas shopping, buy the seafood, I pray, Lord, that you will remind us that Christmas is all about Jesus, that Christmas is all about the birth of the King, that you would enable us to ponder and to question for ourselves, how do we respond to Jesus? In your name, amen.